This is Christopher with AG Productions. Welcome to another edition of Watch Me Work on Ulrich the Slayer, our very cool Space Wolves fella here. What I'm going to work on today is I'm going to try and at least lay down the base coat for these pelts that we see here. I'm not going to work on the pelts that are up on the shoulders because that's going to tie into the pelting that is kind of falls over the front that we haven't attached yet, so there's no sense in working on that. But once I get the base coat laid down for that, I'm probably going to spend the rest of the video cleaning up all of these highlights that I did in the previous video, and I'm hoping I can do all that before I have to go to work. So, first things first, I've got a little bit of paint laying on my palette here. I need to add some water into it because I'm going to kind of sort of pseudo wet blend, and so I need the paint to be a little bit drippy. Now, I'm not overly thrilled. There's dust on my miniature. I'm not overly thrilled about how I'm going to have to do this. I would prefer to have the light color of these tails up next to this little attachment point right here. The problem is, if I do that, it's going to be next to a gold attachment point, and that's going to look really weird to have like a light beigey kind of white color right next to a gold. It's just not going to play well. And so, I've got to put the light color towards the tip of the tail, which, if I recall correctly, and it's been a while since I've seen a lot of wolf pictures, I probably should have looked some up before I started this particular section of my day. I think most of the time the darker section of the tail is towards the tip, because that's the section that takes all the weathering and all the damage. So, I don't know. I suppose in the end it doesn't really matter a lot, but it would be nice to do it fairly similar to reality, but I know that's not always possible. So, I've got my kind of light base color put down, so now I'm going to come back in and just lay down a little bit of a darker color kind of up near the top. As I said, sort of keeping both the colors wet, that way they kind of mix into each other. Again, not overly concerned with the overall look here right now. Just want to lay down the base. Lay it down. I always forget when I turn the model over, I should probably look at the viewfinder of the camera to make sure I'm still in frame. Okay, good, I am. Alright. Now, focus is a whole different other thing. I don't know if I'm in focus or not. Am I? Mostly. Sure. What if I introduce the brush? Yep, still in focus. Great. Okay, so that's pretty good. I'm going to take a little more brown. No, I'm going to move on to the inner pelt between the legs there. Work on it for a moment. While this one kind of dries up a little bit. And all I'm going to do here, I'm not even going to do the, I guess I will do the whole thing. Why not? I was going to say I'm only going to do the outside, because it's so much bigger than the rest of them, but I'll go ahead and do the whole thing. It's not going to kill me. Again, just really laying down kind of a color onto which I can put other colors. That's really all I want to do right here. Alright. And then this will come this way, kind of like so. And over here. And I hope that I don't get any on the black. That's one of the reasons I'm doing this right now instead of doing it later. Because I would like to avoid having to clean the black up more than once. But we'll see what happens. Alright, so that part is basically done. I need a little more color over here to kind of flesh that out some. And then this part needs to be colored in. Okay, how far up does this go? The picture doesn't show me. So I'm going to have to guess. I'm going to guess that that is a piece of fur. I may be wrong, but that's how it's going to be on my miniature. As Bob Ross used to say, now is the time for big decisions. Just make a big decision and stick with it. And if you don't like it, just scrape all the paint off the canvas. Or in our case, just dunk your model in a vat full of super clean and wait a day and you're good to go again. Alright, so there's that. So now I'm going to come into the center of all that junk. Throw down some brown. blob. There we go. Okay. Again, this is not in any way meant to be professional looking. This is just me laying down some paint. I guess in the end, it'll probably look somewhat professional. I hope it does. I'm a professional painter. I don't necessarily mean that in an elitist way. I just mean that I do sell my finished products. And I guess technically, if you make money off of what you do, you are kind of a professional. Although I've seen some eBay stuff that would make me question that phrase. Pro painted. Really? Looks like you went at it with a Wagner power sprayer. Alright. But that's mean. I probably shouldn't say that. That might be somebody's best effort that they've been able to do so far. And is, I tend to remind everyone, anytime they take one of my classes, what Dennis Waitley used to say, there never was a winner who wasn't a beginner. So we all have to start somewhere. Trying to avoid the knee pad, though I don't know how much success I'll have. It's not bad, although if I do touch it, it's not going to kill things. Yeah, a little contact. A little bit of contact. That's okay. Alright, will that be covered up? No, it won't be. So that'll be exposed, so it still needs to be pretty dark in there. That's fine. We can fix that. We can fix it. And then doing the same thing I did on the other tail, just kind of bringing some darker color in here. Maybe bringing that to, I don't know, maybe that far down. Okay. More paint in the brush. Bring that color down some more. Alright, so one of the things I'm going to have to do is I'm going to have to get some color inside. This little area right here, there's a little nook between this fluffy tail and this pelt right here on the body, and I can see right through it into some of the primer area of the miniature. So I'm going to introduce a little brown down into that hole, and hopefully once the model is finished, you won't even notice. We got that taken care of. Let me cap this brush again. Is that the right cap? Sure, why not? It fits. And let me go back to my other brush, and we will do some more brown adding up in here. Okay, this one's pretty good right there. I can deal with that. This one needs a little bit more up top. Alright, so you can see we've kind of got a little bit of a fade going on, especially in this one right here. And that's kind of what I want. I just want to prep this for later on when I actually do come in with some of that paint or some of the highlight colors. I just want to have a general rough outline of kind of where the transitions are going to be. Because you can see they've got this nice... Let me blow the dust off that. They've got this nice... kind of faded thing that goes from, you know, dark at the top down to light at the bottom. And if you don't break that in your base coat, it's going to be really hard to do. So, that's what I'm doing. Alright, and I think, let me do a little bit more brown right here. I don't really have to do it now because I'm not near any of the black surfaces, so there's no real chance of me contacting that while I'm doing this, but may as well get it done while I've got the paint out and it's on my palette and wet. Alright, there we go. I can deal with that. Now, let's move on to the black. Okay, so let me cap this brush, because this will kill me when I do clean up. And let's pick a different brush now. Let's go with a 00. And I need black now, so let's do this. Alright, good. We're halfway there. As far as video time goes. So, a little black onto the palette. And it's cleanup time. A lot of water. Okay. I need basically a liner for this, because that's kind of what I'm doing. Alright. Let's start with the kneecaps, since that's the messiest area now that I've colored it in about four different colors. Little touch of black right there behind it. Nothing major. Just to kind of differentiate those two lines. Alright, and let's do this. Okay, just an edge highlight. That's all we've got. Now, let's go ahead and paint that black so that's not offensively the wrong color. Okay, so this is a square highlight, so it needs to be fixed on the bottom edge. Okay. This is one of those things that I do that I don't recommend necessarily for a newer painter because it requires a great deal of brush control. But if you want to give it a shot, you're welcome to. It's just not unbelievably easy. If you're good with a pen or a pencil in drawing a very straight line, you might be all right. But give it a go if you want to. Again, if you want to learn in depth what I'm doing, how I'm doing it, check out the Let's Paint Black Templars DVD set. Shameless self-promotion, once again. I keep doing that. Why? Because. Alright, there's that. And let's put a little more right there. Good. Okay. Let's do that there. There. Perfect. Alright. Now let's move to, I guess, the feet. Kind of been avoiding the feet, but that's okay. I've got too much paint. There we go. I can tell a lot of the time when I have too much paint, I get ready to put the brush down, and it's like there's just this, when I compare what my brush looks like to what the miniature looks like, the brush is like four times bigger than it normally is, so I know I've got way too much paint in the bristles. So, go back to the paper towel, and wipe it off. Okay. And gently, 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 gently. So very finicky area. Lots of detail right here. Needs to stay detail. Alright, and then I'll hit the front. Slightly, I apologize if I'm not got the miniature tilted in the direction he needs to be. I needed to access something on the front, and it was going to be tough to do so that you guys could see it. Alright, so let's thin this out on the top first. Okay. Go. And from the bottom, a little bit too much paint. There we go. Excellent. All right. Now we do the bottoms. So let's do the top of the bottom first. We'll do the top of the bottom before we do the bottom of the bottom. How about that? Makes sense. Hope so. Alright. I don't know if you guys can see my hand shaking or not. But, much like a beginner, my hand still shakes. One way to counteract that is to exhale as you make your brush stroke, but it doesn't always work, at least not to the fullest extent. I mean, it does work to a point, but You will have a little shutter in your hand still. I've never figured out a good way to completely get rid of it. You can come darn close. Another way to minimize the shake of your hand is to not care. A lot of the handshake is due to dexterity issues, being able to control the brush at a very, very specific angle for a very slow and tedious and exact precise stroke. But a lot of it is simply nerves of wanting the miniature to look as good as possible. So when you can get to the point where you really don't care, you're just putting down paint. Whatever happens, happens. A lot of times your painting will, A, get better, but B, your strokes will be much more fluid, a lot less bumpy and jumpy. That's a technical term. Okay, now we come to the back here. We'll just touch this and play clean up on the left foot. And see what kind of time we have after we're done there.
Excellent. Okay, so do you see the difference between the left foot and the right foot? And all that detail up here in the knee and these little squares and dots and things up here. Much, much more subtle now
that I've done a little bit of cleanup work. So let's do the right leg. And if we have time, I may do the arm, but I may save that for after I come home from work. We'll see. For right now, let's do the left or the right foot. Okay, so I'm going to do front part of this first, just to establish a nice clean line. And once that's established, move into the actual cleanup part. Just a hint of color. A little bit more. There we go. All right, so there's that. And then let's see here. Spin the model. Okay, I think that's probably good enough. Now let me do the actual foot part or the base of the foot. Just kind of varying things a little bit from the way I did it the last time. No real reason other than just want to be different. Excellent. And then we'll do the front and make it much more subtle highlight. If I was really good, I could do this without the cleanup, but I'm not that good. I admit, I'm just not that good of a painter. I'm not bad, but I'm not great. Okay. All right, a little bit more paint in the brush. Excellent.
All right, so feet are done. You see that? Back him up a little bit so you can see. Actually, let me just stand him up. There we go. All right, so you can see
much, much cleaner, more simplistic look than the arms up there. We're at the, we're about 19 and a half minutes in, so we'll go ahead and end here for right now. I'm going to go ahead and go to work, and then when I get home, I'll come back and finish up the upper torso. I'm going to start working on the pelts, maybe. I may do the face, actually, instead, because I'm really kind of annoyed at that gigantic white ball that's sitting on top of all the black armor. So I may end up doing the face next, but we'll see. I don't know yet. We'll find out when I get home.
For right now, though, thank you very much for watching. If you have any comments or questions, please feel free to leave those in the comment section down below. Also, be sure to leave a thumbs up on this video and subscribe to AG Productions if you haven't done so already. Again, thank you for watching. God bless you all. Have an awesome rest of the day, and I will see you all in the next video.